Hi guys, welcome to the channel. In this video, we shall discuss how do metals and non-metals react with each other, right? Okay, in your previous classes, you have learned that the noble gases, they have a completely filled valence shell. Because they have completely filled valence shell, they show little chemical reactivity. That means they do not take participation in the chemical reaction at all. So therefore, we explain the reactivity of elements as a tendency to attain a completely filled valence shell. Any element, for it to be reactive, it has to have a outermost filled, completely filled shell, right? So let us look at the electronic configuration of some of the metals, non-metals and noble gases. In this table, first you can see that noble gases, helium, neon and argon. Helium has 2 electrons in its outermost shell, that is K shell. Neon has 8 electrons in L shell and argon has 8 electrons in the M shell. Similarly, the metals like sodium, magnesium, aluminium and potassium and calcium, they have 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2 electrons in their outermost shells, whereas the non-metals, they have 5, 6, 7, right? So you must remember that every element wants to settle down, just like everyone else wants to settle down in their life. How do they settle down? By achieving an octet. What is an octet? They want to have 8 electrons in their outermost shell. It means that they want to achieve the noble gas configuration. Okay. So if you look at that table, the sodium has 1 electron in its outermost shell. And if it loses 1 electron from the M shell, then the L shell becomes the outermost shell. And you can say it has a complete stable octet, right? So you also know that the number of protons is always equal to the number of electrons in an atom. Therefore, an atom is electrically neutral. So if it has 11 protons and if it loses 1 electron, the number of electrons that is going to remain is 10. So therefore, there will be a net positive charge on sodium, and therefore it becomes Na plus ion. Similarly, if you take a chlorine, the atomic number of chlorine is 17. The electronic configuration is, in the K shell it has 2, in the L shell it has 8, and in the M shell it has 7. Now, is it easy to lose 7 electrons or to gain 1 electron? So quite obviously, it is very easy to gain one electron rather than losing 7 electrons. So what happens is, the chlorine is going to gain 1 electron, which is lost by the sodium. After gaining 1 electron, the number of protons in the chlorine remains 17, whereas because it has gained 1 electron from sodium, it has got now 18 electrons, which means the net charge on the chloride ion will be minus 1. So therefore, there is a give and take relationship between sodium ion and chloride ion. So Na becomes Na plus and Cl becomes Cl minus. You can see the formation of the sodium chloride ion here. The sodium is going to lose one electron and it is going to become sodium cation. And chlorine is going to accept that electron and it is going to become chloride ion by the transfer of these electrons. So sodium and chloride ions, now being oppositely charged, they are going to attract each other and they are going to be held by a strong electrostatic force of attraction and now exist as a ionic compound called a sodium chloride. The formula is NaCl, right? So these compounds, which are formed by the transfer of electrons, here the sodium is going to transfer the electron to chlorine. So therefore, this compound is formed by the transfer of electrons. So those compounds which are formed by transfer of electrons are called as ionic compounds. I hope you guys understood it. Okay. Thank you guys.